Yo, what's going on, y'all? It's your boy Cody Mack from What's the Word, and what makes me sincere is my determination to leave a legacy.
What's good, man?
Bro,
how you feeling?
I'm feeling good, boss.
Man, appreciate you, bro, for coming out, supporting us, and coming
appreciate
out.
Appreciate y'all having me, man.
Yeah, G, much love. But let's get off, man. Like, you know, how did this start? How did What's the Word begin? Give us the first day, the first installment of you thinking about this.
Alright, so the first installment of What's the Word actually happened in college. I was with a few of my fraternity brothers, and we were just joking around. And I was like, yo, what if we just start a show on campus, and it's just us, and then at the end of it, we just go out strolling, you know, and we just gonna call it What's the Word. The original host was going to be one of my fraternity brothers, Chill, because that was like his saying on campus. Like, every time he pick up the phone, he'd be like, what's the word? What's the word? So it's like, you know, kind of took it from him. But when he transferred, I'm like, the idea was still stuck in my head. Like, I'm going to do it. So I did it as a show on campus. If you look it up, it's an old clip. Like, it was just a show. It was a different segments. And as of when I graduated, I took that concept instead of it being like a show, like how we doing right now, and just made it into like different like episodes and different like, you know what I'm saying, TV shows, different concepts on a platform. So took the show name and just turned it to What's the Word as a publication.
Okay. Which campus is this?
Southern Illinois Carbon.
Southern Illinois. Yeah. And just for everybody to know, what fraternity are you in?
Kappa Alpha Psi, the best fraternity in the world.
What was that process like from taking it from a college campus to bringing it, you know, to a big city like Chicago?
That was probably one of the hardest things that I ever. No, pleasant part. that was probably the second hardest thing that I ever done in my life, because when you it's new, you know, and it's you coming from you being a big fish in a small pond, of Carbondale. Now you're just like you're a small fish in a city with 400 million people. Yeah. I mean, 4 million people. So, you know what I'm saying? So it was definitely difficult.
True. So like what? So being that it was difficult, like what would be the number one, I guess, tip that you would tell somebody to like take something from being a college environment? Because you know, everybody starts something in college, right? Mm-hmm. But if they want to take it to a Chicago level or a city level, like what was your number one tip to get from that to the city?
To bring what you do in college to the city?
Yeah, well, for your platform in particular.
I would say the number one thing is persistence, man.
It's persistence.
You gotta have persistence. Like, just always thinking the end game, you know? That's if you got the end game in mind, you know, everything in your day-to-day won't, because you're gonna go through a lot. A lot of hardships, man. A lot of failure, you know? A lot of lessons. I won't call them losses. I'm gonna say you're gonna learn a lot of lessons. But you just gotta have that persistence.
Who would you say your biggest influence in life has been, or through this process, whatever you want to take it?
My biggest influence, like, as like individuals, or just like...
Period, however you want to take it.
Well, I would say my idols, the people that I idolized when I started this platform and things, are people like Steve Jobs, Kanye West, Walt Disney, you know, people like that, actually Chicago native, Henry Abbott, you know, from Chicago Defender, you know, so things like that.
Funny enough about Kanye West, I mean, we can't talk about him in the media right now. how do you feel about, you know, one, his rants, and then his, you know, most latest comments about slavery and all of that?
I hope I don't get ridiculed for this, but I think Kanye West is a genius, man. I think as creators, and you guys probably can test, you guys in fashion, you guys are creators, and sometimes it's hard to articulate what you're trying to say. And I forgot who I was watching the interview on. I want to say it was Nipsey Hussle. When we interviewed Nipsey Hussle, he was saying that you got to learn not to judge people. It wasn't Nipsey Hussle, because that was a gay thing he posted on Instagram. So it was like, and I have nothing against homosexual people at all, you know what I'm saying? He said, we got to learn as people to not judge people off the words they're saying, but their intent, you know? So we can't be surface thinkers. Like if I say something, it's like the Iverson soundbite, the practice.
Right.
Like he couldn't, you know, he just lost a playoff game. Mm-hmm. One of his closest friends just got murdered, and you asking him a question about practice.
Yeah.
And he telling you like we're gonna sit here and talk about practice. And that's like the sound like the media took, you know? And when you know when you got a lot of stuff going on, it's hard to articulate what you're trying to say up here, you know, the business communication is hard.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So I feel like with Ye, I feel like Ye was really trying to say something.
Mm-hmm.
But the way it came out, even like 2 seconds after he said the slavery thing, he said, I'm not even gonna say slavery, because that's talking about black people, I'm talking about prison in the mind.
Mm-hmm.
But no one even paid attention to that part. You know what I mean? They just stuck on him saying slavery was a choice.
Right.
So, yeah.
What's the word in the next 5 years?
5 years, me and Robin just talking about this. My sister over there, Robin, we just talking about this. Shout out to Robin, man. 5 years, I see what's the word as a platform being like the media outlet in Chicago. You know?
That's right.
You know, covering not just hip hop, you know, sports, you know, politics. Might have some visual series coming up, movies, you know, but in 5 years, I want to be that publication. When people come from media in Chicago, they stop it.
Right.
You know.
Now, are you full-time invested in this, or do you also have like a full-time gig outside of it?
Nah, this is full-time.
Full-time?
I'm hustling.
That's
24/7, man.
Yeah. At what point did you decide, like, were you ever just doing this on the side, or has it always just been full-time?
At one point in time when I first graduated college, it was like part-time. I was actually working at a bank, making about 50 bands and 50 racks a year at a bank, you know, and I hated it, you know, and it came to a choice where I had to stay at the bank or get another opportunity, and I let the bank go to do this.
That's really real. How'd you feel making that decision? Let me ask you this, how did your family feel when you made that decision?
Everybody, especially my mom looked at me like I was crazy. My grandma looked at me crazy, you know, because in our community where we come from, you know, you get a job at a bank or you get a college degree, they think, you know, you made it, you know what I'm saying? That was making it for us, you know? So it was like, you really gonna do this to follow your dream, to be an entrepreneur, like, you know? Mm-hmm. I got so much
heat for that.
So much heat.
Man, I'm all
so much heat.
Well, like, how would you compare what's the word to other media outlets in Chicago, or even just across the Midwest?
I hate to compare, but I would say what differentiates us from them is that a lot of media outlets in the city of Chicago like to focus on like hip hop culture.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only thing. Up and coming rappers, up and coming artists, and stuff like that. That's not really our aim, you know. Mm-hmm. Our aim is to, even though Chicago urban culture is our niche, just mm-hmm. so we, you know, but we just different because we don't do that. You know? Mm-hmm. Our aim is to tell stories and, you know, enlighten people or what's going on around. You know, hopefully they can be entertained or provide them information and help them go on in their everyday life. Probably the biggest thing that differentiates it from us.
Okay. It's crazy that you said, you know, you guys don't focus on like hip hop or the music and all that. You had an upcoming MC list that just came out and it kind of like took over the city. How, you know, what did you think about that? What made you want to go out and, you know, do that?
Because I'm a hip hop journalist. You know, hip hop is my thing. You know, the platform, you know, is got sports, you know. And I have politics, people that's into politics, but hip hop is my thing as an individual. So yeah, I put that list out there because, you know, I love the music.
Mm-hmm.
I watch all these artists. You know, I'm here. Like I said, I'm at the Holden Walls. I'm at the studio sessions. Like I put in my
time,
100,000 hours, what they like to say.
Mm-hmm.
So I do that. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I just wanted to get a city that I feel like it was time to take that step to be controversial.
And you was right. Look at Valet. He on top. You had my number one. So you was right. You doing something right.
Yeah, Valet, I put a tweet on Facebook. I posted on my page like 2 weeks ago, but it was on Facebook like months ago, like November.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, man, like y'all are sleep on this kid, Valet. And like, it's like I've been on Juice WRLD for a minute, like texting, kicking it, you know what I mean? Like just saw him and he was just, you know.
What you working on?
What
What's
I got?
The word?
What we got next? What we got next? Actually May 19th, we got this party called Lil Litty. It's themed a trap wave. So it's gonna be like for the collegiate age group, like 18, 23. That's our type of items for it. But anybody is welcome. Glow sticks, lasers, smoke, like bringing experiences back. So that's one thing that I do here. What's the word? I see that the culture is so, I'm gonna say the right word for it. It's so, I wanna say gentrified. I don't know if that's the right word to say, but it's like the culture is not, it's not the same no more, you know?
Diluted.
Yeah, it's like, it's not the same no more. When you go to a party, it'd be the same thing, you know?
See the same faces, do the same thing.
Everybody's pointing, everybody's on Instagram, no one's going to those parties where they like, man, that was an experience, I gotta go back, you know? And that's what I want to provide with, you know what I'm saying, with the Lil Litty party. It's gonna be a brand, ongoing brand, and it's gonna blow to some, like, Lollapalooza big before, you know, urban, you know, people.
That's real. I feel that.
You know.
That's definitely an experience. So you talking like lasers, glow sticks, what you said?
Yeah, it's gonna be glow sticks, fog machines, all that type of stuff.
Oh yeah, we've been in a little while, so that's definitely gonna be something to go to. You said it's May 19th, right?
May 19th. Yeah. We got this location called The Cave. It's like a hidden location in Bronzeville. So it's gonna be dope. And you know it's a rave, so it kind of go hand in hand.
Take on back a little bit. You know, nowadays talking about rave, but you
yeah, it's a rave, so it's gonna be dope. It's gonna be dope. Private party. We aiming for it to be the best party of summer.
How was growing up in Chicago influenced you and your drive or just your business as a whole?
Growing up in the city influenced me a lot because the lack of resources and information is like the biggest downfall for like African American urban people in the city of Chicago. So it was like, you know, you always got a hunger for something, thirst for more, like, you know, you don't want to go back to this. It's like, that was the ambition, that drive. So now when it brings to the business, I understand, like, I got to give these people information, you know, all the information, the keys and tools I got, because there's no platform that really do it, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like, got to give you information, get to give you what we don't got to change the community, you know what I'm saying? Change, if you notice on my platform, that we don't post like fights, we try to stay away from like twerk videos and stuff like that because it's a certain image that we like to paint. You know what I mean?
It trains the mind.
Yeah. So when you watching our stuff and our content, you know, like this, like whoever will see, like y'all into fashion, you know, y'all got an interview series going on. Like this is the type of stuff that people growing up, like people like me would have been like, I would have known some brothers can do that.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, Ye was saying, like, fashion is a European industry. You know what I mean? So if I'm gonna go see who a blogger or anybody a platform that's delivering fashion, it's probably gonna be, you know, some white people.
Right. Yeah.
But y'all not, you know? But that information needs to be out there, you know? So that's what, you know, the influence Chicago, that lack of information and resources kind of drove me. And now I'm putting that same thing on my platform because I want other people to have those resources. You know, I want to pave the way for the next generation to be like, yo, we ain't gotta go to the Shade Room, Ball Alert, all see celebrity news. We can find out that we have a trauma center on the South Side now. People don't know about that, you know?
Right.
But, you know what I mean? My first one since 1991.
Right.
You know what I mean?
That's big facts.
So for the people out there who don't know where to find you, what's your website, social media?
Everything is What's the Word TV. The website is whatstheword.tv. If you want to look up me personally, I have an Instagram. It's Cody Mack 3Ks. I'm controversial, that's why I put 3Ks. But I bet you remember it. But yeah, that's where y'all can find me. Subscribe to us on YouTube at What's the Word. You know, subscribe to the mailing list. It's there, you know, so you can get the word.
Well, we appreciate you on this special edition episode of Sincerely Richard.